Hello and welcome back to iPad Lettering. My name is Karen and I'm here to help you get the most out of your iPad, whether that is with lettering or art or journaling. In today's video, I want to show you one of the brand new Procreate 5X features, which are the new snapping tools. And the best way to demonstrate these features is by actually creating this perfect snowflake. By the end of this video, you will know how to use the new snapping feature and you'll be able to make this beautiful snowflake yourself. All right, so now we're going to go back to the gallery and create a new canvas. The canvas size that we are going to use is 2048 by 2048 pixel, which is just that square canvas. And then we are going to turn on the grid lines as well. So you tap on the actions icon. And then in the canvas menu, you see here that it says drawing guide. So you can turn this on. So you have the grid lines. If it doesn't quite look like this, you can edit the drawing guide and you can change the grid size. You can change the color, the thickness and the opacity of your grid. My grid size is set to 65 pixels, the thickness is 64% and the opacity is 36%. The brush that I'm going to use for the snowflake is my Totally Crispy brush. You don't necessarily have to use this brush. You can use any monoline brush that's included in Procreate. I'm going to set that size of my brush to 30%. Now, if a snowflake is a perfect hexagon, so the way we're going to draw it is like this. Except, of course, we're going to make it much nicer. I just wanted to show you the concept. So now we're going to start drawing our snowflake and we're going to start by just creating a straight line like this. You want it to be about half the width of the canvas and you're going to hold down your Apple pencil and you never lift it up. And if you hold down your finger, you can see that the line snaps into place at 15 degree angles. So you want this to be perfectly straight like this. And then we're ever so slightly going to decrease the brush size. Maybe 27% is good. And we're going to create some additional little embellishments here for our snowflake. So you can create maybe two or three of these if you like. And then we're going to copy this twice. So I'm going to go duplicate and duplicate again. And then I'm going to turn the visibility of the bottom layer off just to keep this as a spare copy in case I need to go back to the original layer. And then with the top layer selected, select the black arrow tool and then flip the shape horizontal like this. And then make sure that you've got the snapping set on. Turn on magnetics and also turn on snapping. And then the distance is set to 8 and velocity to max. So now we can move this shape to the side and make it overlap with that shape below like this. And so this is the first part of our snowflake done. So now we can combine the two layers like this. You can tap on merge down. And that's one part of the snowflake finished. So now what we're going to do is duplicate this. And this time we're going to flip the shape vertical and then we can move it down. It doesn't matter how far you move it down. Something like this looks nice. And then we are going to merge down the shape like this. And then we're going to duplicate it. And now we are going to rotate this shape. So what you can do now is grab the green handle and then you can rotate it. You can see now how you can rotate this really nicely. And for the snowflake, we want it rotated exactly 60 degrees like this. And then we're going to do the exact same thing again. Duplicate the shape, use the black arrow tool, and then rotate the shape 60 degrees again. And this is our snowflake done. How easy was that? So now all we have to do is merge all the layers together and then we can place that shape in the center of the page. And you can check that that shape is exactly in the center of the page because it's got the yellow lines here. And now we are finished. So this is a super easy way of making a snowflake in Procreate using the brand new Procreate 5X snapping features. I really hope you found this video useful. Please give me a thumbs up, subscribe to my channel if you haven't already. And then I'm also going to bloop up another couple of videos with Procreate 5X features so you can keep watching and you can keep learning those as well. Thank you so much for watching and I'll see you in my next video.